Welcome to the International Day of People of African Descent. My name is Derek Leon Washington. As your host, I'm happy to be part of this experience. This experience that shows how art and cultural expression can share the obstacles, resilience, and defiant joy of peoples. But first, I acknowledge I'm in Brooklyn, New York. Traditional homeland and territory of the Canarsie. The Canarsie are a Munsee-speaking Lenape bands, or Delaware people. So I give respect to the Canarsie, all Lenape, past, present, and future. So for the International Day of the World's Indigenous Peoples, we were at United Nations headquarters, and we focused on the art and cultural expressions there. But today, we're gonna travel around New York City to look at these cultural expressions and how they show defiant joy. We'll see different peoples like the Soapbox Presents, where they create spaces where people can rejuvenate and resist. We'll look at samba, how samba is a declaration of joy and life. We'll look at bomba, bomba as ritual, bomba as community, bomba as a grito, or a shout of life. Also, I have a UN colleague. We've never danced before, but showing how dance can be a universal language, how we can share our stories, we can be cool, we can be intense, we can improvise, and even though we're coming from different spaces, we can connect. So in conclusion, we'll talk about what the United Nations is doing to fight for the human rights of people of African descent, but also what can you do locally. Put your comments and ideas in the chat section, the comment section, but let's get started on this adventure.
Resistance, but this too is a form of resistance. These drums, we resist by playing them. We sing, we resist by singing. We resist by speaking these words. We resist by hitting these keys. We resist by dancing. We resist by laughing. We resist by loving. We resist by feeding our families. We resist by having that sensual time with your mate. We resist in all sorts of ways. We resist by being joyful, because joy is a revolutionary act. One more time, joy is a revolutionary act.
La diversidad racial del caribeño es notablemente mayor que en otras regiones del mundo. Somos una región de paso, zona de fronteras entre grandes potencias. Sobre la cultura dominicana coinciden tres fuentes de identidad cultural: la de los pueblos aborígenes, la identidad hispánica y la identidad africana o afroantillana. Entre antropólogos e historiadores existe la convicción de que la influencia africana es una riqueza más de nuestra cultura y está muy presente y viva en la sociedad dominicana actual. Su influencia en la música se manifiesta en nuestro folclore popular, mezclando expresiones religiosas y culturales, siendo los más destacados los atabales, palos, zarandungas, música de baile afrodominicano, los congos, las salves, el gagá y los cantos de hacha. Los instrumentos utilizados por ellos, los tambores, la marimba, la gallumba, etc. Esta tradición musical, más notable en el área de Villa Mella, usa en sus ritos religiosos y celebraciones seculares instrumentos mayormente de percusión. Entre ellos sobresale un variado número de tambores. Nuestra tambora es un instrumento clave en la estructura rítmica del baile nacional, el merengue. La palabra bachata designa la juerga, el jolgorio y la parranda. En sí es un afronegrismo que proviene de la palabra africana cumbancha, de la que nació cumbachata y de esta por aféresis bachata. Cumbancha, cumbanchero, cumbanchar, aún de uso corriente en el país, de cuyo mismo origen debe ser la palabra cumandé, empleada como estribillo en un pintoresco baile popular, según Fernando Ortiz Fernández. Yo no sabía, cumandé, que usted bailaba, cumandé. Por eso yo, cumandé, no la invitaba, cumandé. Los negros esclavizados llamaban bachata a sus grandes fiestas. En la República Dominicana, entre los años 1950 y 1960, la bachata solo era escuchada y bailada por la gente más humilde en los lugares más desfavorecidos socialmente. Pero para la década de los 80, la bachata da un salto importante y empieza a escucharse en emisoras de radio y otros medios. Aumenta el número de cantantes y conjuntos bachateros, llegando al público de todas las clases sociales. En 1990, Juan Luis Guerra graba Bachata Rosa, dando una dimensión diferente e internacional a este estilo musical, marcando para siempre la música tropical y por ende la música dominicana. Narra Rodríguez de Morici que el magistrado doctor García Gautier, en una audiencia, preguntó a un campesino: ¿qué era bachata? Y él le contestó: adiós, romo, tambora y cuero. Algunas de las tradiciones carnavalescas que nos dejaron como herencia y que podemos citar, personajes como Califé, Roba la Gallina o Diablos Cojuelos, que se entremezclan con tradiciones de otros países. Importantes también son los guloyas o buloyas de San Pedro de Macorís, los cuales forman parte de la cultura y la historia de nuestro país, también declarados Patrimonio Cultural de la Humanidad. La gastronomía dominicana. En esta área nos dejaron costumbres alimenticias, sabores y aromas que agregan valor y la forma de preparar estos alimentos, como es el escabeche, los sofritos, el ñame, los guineos, el chacá, el bollo, el chenchen, la comida con coco, con conete y el domplín. También se enriqueció nuestra cocina con platos como el mofongo, pasteles en hoja de plátano, moro de guandules, morcillas, longanizas y chicharrones, bien integrados a la gastronomía criolla.
Well, you know, born and raised in New York, one thing I could tell you, I never learned about my own history. And it was through bomba that I really got to learn about my history. Bomba is not Spanish, it's not English, it's not French, right? It's a language, it's a humanity language. Bomba is an Afro-Puerto Rican art form. Being Puerto Rican is so confusing today. But what gives me more clarity is the Afro-Puerto Rican. The Afro-ness, the Afro-ism of being Puerto Rican is what, you know, what Bomba gives me. And that's just keeping it real.
Start.
Well, the samba in Rio de Janeiro started in the hills, in a shanty house, which we call favela, and people that were marginalized would gather together in the end of the religion ceremonies just to celebrate and to dance and to play music and to be together. Dance, it is joyful. There's no way that you can hear the drums and hold yourself just to hear the drums and the energy. Even you see the players playing the music, there's no way that they can stay still. So there is joy on that. Release of all your stress, of all your sorrows. And be ready for the next, and be awake and be and acknowledge your worth, mm-hmm. acknowledge your own power. Ancestors to the world, because they with the music, with the way of keeping the traditions and the art alive, they still find ways to invite everyone to join in and contribute. And I think that's what makes samba so powerful also, is that inclusion. Make sure that with the roots in Africanism.
At United Nations headquarters, art of Africa and the African diaspora can show abundance and fertility like the Nimba mask of the Baga people of Northeast Guinea. It can show gender and express gender like the Gruo sculptures. It can create beautiful sounds like the steel pan drums of Trinidad and Tobago. The Ark of Return invites audiences to remember the legacies of the slave trade and how we all can fight against racism and prejudice today. Dance is also an art and cultural expression. It can connect people from different nationalities and ethnic backgrounds. Dance can be a universal language. Thank you.
art and cultural expression shares the joys, beliefs, and values of a people. So what is the United Nations doing? There is the recent creation of the Working Group of People of African Descent. There's a Committee on the Elimination of Racial Discrimination, CERD. Recently, as of August 2021, the 193 member body unanimously adopted a resolution establishing the United Nations permanent form of people of African descent. In June 2021, United Nations Human Rights released the High Commissioner's Report on Racial Justice and Equality. And a four-step agenda says this: step up, stop denying, and start dismantling. Pursue justice, end impunity, and build trust. Listen up, people of African descent must be heard. And lastly, redress, confront past legacies, take special measures, and deliver reparatory justice. But what can you do locally? First, support your local artists. Support people who are sharing art, who are creating art. Support people who support our local food systems, who pick our food. And in the comments below, ask questions, make comments. How are you working in your local communities to fight for justice and allowing for people of African descent to show defiant joy? Thank you.